Well, hello folks, my name's Ian, and thank you if you're following along this coffee table recycling build. Now, the series of videos, because I think there's going to be another two, I've still got, according to that, even after this video, I've still got another 41 minutes of footage, which I might be able to condense down. The journey, the videos is about my journey on how I'm trying to make something. Yes, I could have just taken it, condensed it all down into 15 minutes, put it up on YouTube, but no one would know the struggle I've been through to do it, you know. So that's what this video's about. It won't appeal to some people. I can't apologise for that. It doesn't appeal to you? Turn it off now. Don't watch it. You want to see a guy struggle mentally? Carry on. So without much of ado, I finished with a piece of paper drawing out a design. I'll take it from there and catch you at the start of the next video. See you soon. Not very high tech this lot, just just a knot together sewing board, just goes in the vise, tighten it up, that's at 90 degrees to there, so anything you put in there and saw, you get a 90 degree cut. This saw, tenon saw, well, this was my granddad's, so I'm going to put it about, whoa, God, 50. It's got to be 70 years old at least, but it still saws. Right, I mean, these go in the corner. What we've got here is a, well, a pyramid shaped thing. So they go in the corner, and then you'll get the block of wood. I got something to nail to that side, and I've something to nail to that side. More sewing in. Hey, well, I'm suffering from artistic block. I hope more homesteading is watching this. So, I just can't do it. So, I've got myself a template. That's this, the actual width of what I want to make. And I've been putting the pieces on in different orientations, and it's hard to tell. So you've just seen me there sand some of those burned marks off. Now, what attracted me to this wood in the first place was when I was at work and the stuff gets wet, yeah, it's just water, kind of pops it out a little, you can see what I mean, a little bit bland, and it does pop it out, and I thought, whoa, that's going to be nice. But there's very little grain to be seen at a distance. Yeah, so as I say, it might look a little bit bland. Now, as I said, I've cut this template. Now, I've got to thank Huey Lionsart for this idea, because I was discussing it with him, and he said, well, I was going to do, as you know, a chevron or a herringbone pattern, and he said it's way better to do on a board than it is as you go along. Well, as I said, and I got this idea now, that there, it doesn't quite pop out. And I thought, what I need is a spacer. Put a couple together, and they aren't quite even. So I thought, I can either plane them all straight, or maybe I can put a spacer between, like that. Okay. And it's like, whoa, that's nice. Red, black, red, black. So I might now put a black spacer in between. So I think here what I'm trying to say is it's, I don't just have this idea and think, go on, get on and do that. No, it takes deliberation. You trial and error, you put things together, it don't look right. So if it don't look right, scrap it. Don't be afraid of saying it don't look right. And if I'm doing it for me, then it don't matter what it looks like to you. I'm sorry to say, it's how does it look to me? You know, they say beauty is in the eye of the beholder. So you can come down, you can see this, and you go, oh, what a pile of crap that is. But if it looks nice to me, it's me that's looking at it. So it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to ponder here and get some, I know what I'll do. I know what I'll do. I'll get some pondering juice down my neck. So this is going to be favourites of mine, Hobgoblin. I know it's a favourite of Cruiser Max. And hopefully that'll release some of the creative juices. Got to be able to look at that, I think. Oh, got those black things with the leaves on. Who would it look like? So I've got to imagine what it's going to look like in the future. And I tell lots of people, I have very little imagination. Yeah, the camper van wood burner I made, I didn't imagine it. I saw it on the internet and I can copy it. But this, well, I've not got anything to copy. This is coming from my imagination. So I'll have some imagination loosening juice and see what I come up with. Hey, okay, I've cut something where I'm hoping to go to be as contrasting strips, and I want those to be a much darker colour than this. Now, at this moment, I'm lacking of creativeness. It's Saturday night, and the guy talking in the background there is it's Boom, Rafael Scrapper.
I have some.
Ian. My fellow Ian.
You know, Irish.
Let's close that.
The thingy are quite good.
Focus. There's me, Rafael, Romantic, JCT, Barry West, Electronic Scrapper.
What?
And I guess there's many. Oh, somebody's saying hello to me there. Yeah,
you know, Electronic Scrapper.
I'm just struggling a little bit here, so I think,
and
I'll pack that in.
Boom.
Think on it overnight.
That's new. It's dated 2018.
Where are we now?
So, last fall, but
8:30 in the evening. So I think I will pack in here in the shed. Go inside, and get showered, and
this device, what you will
carry on watching Rafael and all my friends in chat.
Others.
See you in a little bit.
Well, there comes a point you got to walk away from it. I am stuck. I just don't know which way to go on that old woodworking to make it look right. So I've decided to come in. I've got myself some mozzarella balls, sun-dried tomatoes, chips, some meat and cheese selection. Got a nice Malbec to go with that. After that, we'll have a nice dram of Talisker Stall with some caramel Mexican American pecans and Himalayan pink salt. So we'll get all that set up, and then we'll come and watch these guys chat. That's Ravel, Bill from Scrapping Together, and Ali Mac Mechanical, the second half of Braveheart Scrapper. So I'll get a plate and sort this out, and see you lot in the next one. There, you just hear Tina coming in. Okay, folks, well, it's a new day, and we've come back to this little job where I'm struggling creatively on. One of the, should I say, benefits, joys, if you want to put it that way, of being a collector, dare I say, hoarder, someone who won't throw anything away in case it might come in handy sometime. Well, this is me tub of small paints and collections. Some of these, for example, though, like this Jack Black, still liquid. Well, that came from my granddad's shed, and my granddad's been dead over 40 years, and I don't think it was new when he had it. So let's conservatively say that that's 50 to 60 years old. I think that came from my granddad's shed as well. So anyway, we've opened that one, which is that. Put that on that one, which is walnut, dark oak varnish stain, marker pen. I'm going to open this blackjack paint and see what that looks like. Well, it should be interesting. Like I say, it's liquidy, so probably not been opened for 10, 15 years at least, myself. This is a paint. Do I really want a paint? This is the same wood that I'm using. So, yeah, not bad for 70-year-old paint, 70-year-old paint. So we'll give them a dry. I'll see which one I'm going to use. Well, colouring one in with a marker pen to try it out for size, and I have to say I don't like it. So back to plan one, which was to just fill it in like that. And I have cut myself a piece to go in at the end. Kiss. Keep it simple, stupid. I think in reflection, this is going to be plain at the background to show off the leaves in the metalwork. I'll get this glued up. So I've applied some glue. Just wood glue, stuck them to that, turned it upside down, put a weight on top. But I am gonna just tack a couple of tacks in as well. Now, because I'm so organised, once I've shifted everything, I've had access to my little tubs of assorted fasteners. I never throw a fastener away. I never throw anything away. And I found these. These were my wife's late father's. So my father-in-law. And he used to, in his early days, he used to make clogs. And I've still got some of his clog making tools. So a tiny tack, just what I need, the brass. And for that, you need the right hammer. Now I've not quite got the same selection as CC Scraps, but I do have a nice collection. And now and again, they come in handy. And this one will do just nicely. Actually designed for the job. So just before I show you how I do that, I mean, you can buy a tool. It kind of looks like a screwdriver. Kind of looks like a screwdriver, but it's got a hollow end, and you could put that in and push it in. I do have one of them somewhere. I can't find it. So why is this designed for the job? Well, that's what that flat bit on the end is for. So you can put that there. And with big fat fingers like mine, there's no way I'd be able to hit it with that. But with that, you could just go in between your fingers and thumb and bang it in. And I'll just put one in each just to hold it together before while the glue settles. Or you can do that. You can just press it in. Oh, I shall be able to turn that over, and then I'll be able to give it another sand, a seal, and that'll be one side done. Just clean up the edges and make another three sides to make me box.